Uma Thurman reveals how she thought she was paralyzed after crashing unsafe car that Quentin Tarantino forced her to drive against her will on set of Kill Bill. The crash occurred in 2002 when the pair were in Mexico filming Kill Bill. It was for the famous driving scene where her character is in a convertible. The car had been modified and Thurman feared it was unsafe for her to drive. She claims she begged Tarantino for a double, but he forced her to do it herself. A camera was positioned on the back of the car and filmed Thurman lose control. She smashed into a palm tree and had to be carried away and taken to hospital. It left her with neck pain, a brace and an egg on her head afterwards. For years, she has been trying to obtain the footage, but Miramax has refused unless she agreed not to hold them responsible for any suffering. She refused and has fought with Tarantino to give her the video for 15 years. He recently gave her the video, which she shared with the New York Times. Uma Thurman has shared details of a crash which occurred on the set of Kill Bill in 2002, which was the result of a dangerous stunt she says Quentin Tarantino forced her to perform against her will. The 47-year-old actress revealed the incident in an article with the New York Times on Saturday and provided video footage of it, which she says Tarantino has been withholding from her for 15 years, but finally gave her recently. It shows her struggling to keep control of a convertible car and then crashing into a palm tree and lying completely still for several seconds as crew hands then Tarantino himself rush over. Thurman says she thought she was paralyzed by the stunt and that she had begged Tarantino not to make her perform it. His refusal to listen to her and his alleged coldness to her afterwards felt like dehumanization to the point of death. She said it was indicative of the mistreatment she received by Tarantino and Harvey Weinstein, who she claimed for the first time on Saturday tried to force himself on her during their iconic working relationship. The incident occurred in Mexico in 2002 as they finished filming for Kill Bill Volume 1. It would later be split into two parts by Weinstein, who was the producer. The scene in question is the famous moment Thurman's character at the end of the first film along a winding road. Thurman did not reveal on Saturday whether the finished article was genuinely her driving down a road. She shared a screen grab of it on Instagram in November when she threatened to expose Weinstein for his alleged misconduct of her. She was hesitant about filming it herself and wanted a stunt double to do the difficult driving because, she claimed, the car was unsafe. It had been reconfigured from a stick shift to an automatic and Thurman claimed a crew member expressed concern to her that it was not working properly. Quentin came in my trailer and didn't like to hear no, like any director. He was furious because it cost them a lot of time. But I was scared. He said, I promise you the car is fine. It's a straight piece of road. Hit 40 miles per hour or your hair won't blow the right way and it'll make you do it again. But that was a death box that I was in. The seat wasn't screwed down properly. It was a sand road and it was not a straight road, she said. In the footage she provided to the Times, Thurman is seen plowing into a palm tree then lying back motionless in the immediate aftermath. Crew members and Tarantino rushed over and got her head, bringing her a bottle of water and speaking to her to calm her down. She had to be carried off set and was taken to hospital. The steering wheel was at my belly and my legs were jammed under me. I felt this searing pain and thought, oh my god, I'm never going to walk again. When I came back from the hospital in a neck brace with my knees damaged and a large massive egg on my head and a concussion, I wanted to see the car and I was very upset. Quentin and I had an enormous fight, and I accused him of trying to kill me. And he was very angry at that, I guess understandably, because he didn't feel he had tried to kill me, she said. For years, they continued to fight over it and she begged him to show her the footage but he always refused. Ethan Hawke, her husband at the time, corroborated her account. I approached Quentin in very serious terms and told him that he had let Uma down as a director and as a friend. He said Tarantino was very upset and asked for his forgiveness. Afterwards, Thurman's lawyer sent a letter to Miramax demanding a copy of the video. They refused to give it to her unless she agreed that she would not hold the production company accountable for future pain or suffering. Thurman refused to agree to those terms and has, for the last 15 years, been trying to get the footage from Tarantino himself. The issue has been a thorn in their friendship and working relationship, she said. We were in a terrible fight for years. We had to then go through promoting the movies. It was all very thin ice. We had a fateful fight at Soho House in New York in 2004, and we were shouting at each other because he wouldn't let me see the footage, and he told me that was what they had all decided, she said. After the Weinstein scandal broke, Tarantino gave it to her. She equates it with him atoning for the danger he put her in and the pair on good terms. Quentin finally atoned by giving it to me after 15 years, right? Not that it matters now, with my permanently damaged neck and my screwed up knees. She has since handed it along with her correspondence with Miramax to police in the hope that they will be held accountable. the role left her feeling belittled by Miramax, Weinstein and Tarantino. Harvey assaulted me but that didn't kill me. What really got me about the crash was that it was a cheap shot. I had been through so many rings of fire by that point. I had really always felt a connection to the greater good in my work with Quentin, and most of what I allowed to happen to me and what I participated in was kind of like a horrible mud wrestle with a very angry brother. But at least I had some say, you know? Representatives for Tarantino did not respond to DailyMail.com's request on Saturday morning, nor did Miramax. In her interview, Thurman also claimed that she was sexually attacked by Weinstein in London's Savoy Hotel, sometime after they became acquaintances, while promoting Pulp Fiction. It was such a bat to the head. He pushed me down. He tried to shove himself on me. He tried to expose himself. He did all kinds of unpleasant things. But he did actually put his back into it and force me. You're like an animal wriggling away, like a lizard. I was doing anything I could to get the train back on the track. My track. Not his track, she said. On a previous occasion, she said he tried to proposition her in a hotel steam room, but that she escaped and he ran out. Weinstein, who remains in Arizona maintaining a low profile since the accusations against him emerged in October, admitted the steam room incident, but denied the violence. Mr. Weinstein acknowledges making an awkward pass 25 years ago at Miss Thurman in England after misreading her signals, after a flirtatious exchange in Paris, for which he immediately apologized and deeply regrets. However, her claims about being physically assaulted are untrue. And this is the first time we have heard those details. There was no physical contact during Mr. Weinstein's awkward pass, and Mr. Weinstein is saddened and puzzled as to why Miss Thurman, someone he considers a colleague and a friend, waited 25 years to make these allegations public, noting that he and Miss Thurman have shared a very close and mutually beneficial working relationship where they have made several very successful film projects together. This is the first time we are hearing that she considered Mr. Weinstein an enemy and the pictures of their history tell a completely different story. There will be more detailed response later from Mr. Weinstein's attorney, Ben Braffman. Harvey Weinstein denies attacking Uma Thurman. In response to Thurman's claims, a representative for Weinstein sent photographs to DailyMail.com of the pair together in the years after the attack in an attempt to disprove her. In accompanying statement, they said, "We have pulled a number of images that demonstrate the strong relationship Mr. Weinstein and Ms. Thurman had had over the years, and we wish the New York Times would have published them." Mr. Weinstein acknowledges making an awkward pass 25 years ago at Ms. Thurman in England after misreading her signals, after a flirtatious exchange in Paris, for which he immediately apologized and deeply regrets. However, her claims about being physically assaulted are untrue. And this is the first time we have heard those details. There was no physical contact during Mr. Weinstein's awkward pass, and Mr. Weinstein is saddened and puzzled as to why Ms. Thurman, someone he considers a colleague and a friend, waited 25 years to make these allegations public, noting that he and Ms. Thurman have shared a very close and mutually beneficial working relationship where they have made several very successful film projects together. This is the first time we are hearing that she considered Mr. Weinstein an enemy and the pictures of their history tell a completely different story. There will be more detailed response later from Mr. Weinstein's attorney, Ben Braffman.